Okay, here we go on reading this excerpt from The Trial of George W. Bush by my good friend Terry Jastro. Hope you enjoy it.
The basic premise of this case is this. George W. Bush's armed conflict with Iraq lasted 8 years and 9 months, during which approximately 4,500 American soldiers, hundreds of Iraqi and coalition soldiers, and hundreds of thousands of Iraqi citizens, with some estimates reaching well beyond 1 million Iraqi citizens, were murdered. All of this is to say that if it can be proven that the defendant, George W. Bush, was the single person most responsible for causing the war to happen, and that crimes against humanity or war crimes were in fact committed, then he is criminally liable for those crimes. McBride turned to address the entire courtroom. George W. Bush's initial justification for going to war was that Saddam Hussein had WMD. After it became incontrovertibly evident during the lead-up to the war that Iraq did not have WMD, Mr. Bush shifted his reasoning to the notion that Saddam Hussein was an imminent threat to the security of the United States. When that was proven to be absent of any physical evidence, and totally unlikely, he shifted his story yet again to the higher moral ground of trying to save Iraqi citizens from their leader, Saddam Hussein, specifically referring to regime change. Finally, McBride turned back to the defendant and began his questioning. So, George W. Bush, to get you on the record at last, why did you take America to war with Iraq? Bush responded immediately and forcefully. Following the attacks of 9/11, I made an important decision. The United States would consider any nation that harbored terrorists to be responsible for the acts of those terrorists. Specifically regarding Iraq, my position was that we should be optimistic that diplomacy and international pressure would succeed in disarming Saddam Hussein's regime. But we couldn't allow him to have weapons of mass destruction. I would not let that happen. Will you concede once and for all that Saddam Hussein did not have WMD in 2003, the year you started your war? It's easy for you to arrogantly state now that he didn't have WMD, but if you were charged with protecting 290 million Americans and you weren't sure he didn't have them, and that the last time you'd checked he did have them, you wouldn't be so cocksure of yourself.